sends a message to the shore. So I know forever after I will miss you more and more. It won't be easy.
No,
it won't be easy without you.
No, no.
Reach across the stars, let them know you're with me.
Time is it? Gotcha, little bleeder. You sleep well?
I'm still sleeping.
Go ahead, boss.
Go ahead, boss. What the hell are you talking about?
Where's Nathan's new toy? When we're away from base, he wants a daily 8 o'clock call. Oh, shit, it's not switched on.
Yeah? Well, how come I didn't get to hear about it?
Morning, boss. Maybe because you're not that important.
Well, that seems to be working.
Morning, Colin. What have you got for me?
Listen, okay,
hope I'm not interrupting.
Hello?
Nathan Spring, ISBF Commander. Nathan, this is Ernest
Wolfhartt. Come on, Nathan. Get your bloody finger.
All right, Inspector. Thank you very much.
What does he want to know? I've been
looking forward to meeting
yourself.
Stand
by, will you?
Standing by.
No, there's absolutely zilch in that department.
Will he get used to life out here?
I hope not.
Hey, give me that thing. I'll give him waltz in the till.
Oh, don't wind him up. You know, he just likes to be involved.
Yeah, well, I like to be involved too sometimes. Nathan?
And that effectively means
Nathan.
That we have to be on 24-hour standby. Excuse me, will you? Yes, Kenzie?
Nathan, would you mind telling me why I can...
No, how will you contact them?
I can always try a smoke signal, sir.
This is most untypical. All our equipment is rigorously checked.
Of course.
I'll get on to engineering.
One, engineering. Two, run connections. Three, four. Didn't they teach you anything in that fancy college?
Honestly, I never touched it.
It's your sector. You're responsible. I can't do every bloody thing.
Well, really, I'd be happy to do it myself.
Oh, sure. Then something else goes wrong in front of the safety officer and I get another rollicking. Look at these connections. Just look at them. I'm your wire stripper.
Oh.
A stripper. I said a wire stripper.
Mr. Hooper, I find it very difficult to work with you like this.
Then don't. I didn't ask for you. Go on, get lost.
I'm only trying to help.
Well, you're not. Go on, beat it. You're fired.
You can't fire me.
I can do any bloody thing I like. Now get out of it.
All right, I will.
So, you want to be transferred?
Yes, I can't stand it any longer.
Yes, yes. Well, I know this Mr. Hooper. For all his expertise, he seems to have a difficult personality.
I'd say he was just plain obnoxious. I'm doing my best, but I don't think he likes women.
I don't think he likes anyone at the moment. From what I hear, he's under a good deal of stress.
Well, he's taking it out on me, and I'm afraid I can't tolerate it. I'm sorry.
How long have you been on Moonbase?
5 weeks now.
And this is your first posting in space?
Yes.
Yes. Listen, Beverly, we live a peculiar life here. It's a good deal of tedious routine alternating with periods of extreme stress. We all suffer from overwork, from claustrophobia, sexual frustration, bound to be conflict as a result. But most people who have been out here a few months begin to find that the environment is quite stimulating.
I'll do anything except work with that man again.
But I'm afraid that is where we need you. And however much he denies it, he needs you as well.
Well, he's got a funny way of showing it.
Well, some people have, but you and I know you're doing an excellent job.
Well...
Try it for another week. If you don't like it, we'll transfer you elsewhere. I'll personally give you my reference,
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, come in, Nathan.
Will you give me a reference?
Not if you embarrass me in front of Wolfhartt again.
Who was that?
Oh, it's a new engineer. Apparently her boss is being a bit of a tyrant.
Really? You wanted to see me about something?
Yes, as a matter of fact, it's relevant to her problem. I have been contacted by a psychiatrist, a Dr. Angela Parr. She's doing a project on space psychology and she wants to run some interviews here.
What's that got to do with me?
Well, I think it's an excellent idea, but of course people are naturally suspicious. Perhaps if your staff and mine volunteered, then the others might not object.
Psychiatrist? Well, yes, all right.
You mean you think it's a good idea?
Well, I think we might learn something.
that we're finding. This will, of course, be confidential.
Of course.
So, do you think your people would object?
You mean you want me to make sure that they don't?
Screen on. Hello, this is the ISPF.
Oh, really? So's this.
You got something for us?
I've got something for you, David. Bridge.
Say what?
Seems that it's Wolfhart's favorite game, and we need you to make up a...
Wait a minute, Nathan.
Thank
listen,
you,
I don't play... Nathan!
Screen on.
Can you believe that? God, you know, sometimes I wonder why I ever bothered to join this outfit.
Is it my eyes, or is there a bit of a wobble?
Yes, yes, it's always been like that.
Has it?
One flower.
Well, perhaps we should have it checked. One heart.
Pass.
Pass.
Perhaps you should. Two diamonds.
Two hearts.
I know this table. You know, sometimes it has a mind of its own.
Well, maybe the analyst could talk to it.
Pass.
What analyst?
Oh, we got a shrink. A psychiatrist coming to visit. Just to check on no one's going crazy. Pass.
You don't approve of the idea?
Two no trumps.
Three hearts.
Pass.
Well, is anyone going crazy?
A pass.
Pass.
Three hearts has it then.
No! Oh,
yes!
Not normally like this.
So you keep saying. The reason behind these unscheduled visits is to determine exactly what it's normally like.
Maintenance chief has been rather overstretched.
We all have to work hard. Maybe you should concentrate more on discipline and a little less on amateur psychiatry. I'm leaving on Thursday. I advise you to get everything straightened out before then.
One bloody thing after a bloody another. Rivet driver. Me neither. This is a bloody screwdriver. This is a rivet driver for driving bloody rivets.
You've got problems, Cooper. And you're going to have a whole lot more.
Beverly Anderson says you tried to kill her.
The girl's half-wit. She shouldn't be out here.
She's just finished her training.
She's still half-wit. She still shouldn't be out here.
Yes, well, she's resigned from your department now.
Oh, I should resign. I'll give you all something to think about.
Cooper, I don't think you appreciate the seriousness of this. If you did threaten a colleague's life, you'll never work out here again.
Threaten a colleague's life?
All right, all right.
Well,
what do you call it? What do you call it? An accident? Well, there seems to have been a spate of technical accidents around here just recently.
Are you accusing me or what?
I'm just making an observation, that's all.
Yeah? Well, I suggest you observe it is who keeps this place going. It was only since that transmitter blew that anyone knew I existed. Do you know when my last relief left? 3 bloody months ago. 24 hours a day for 12 bloody weeks.
All right, look, look. Would it help you if I got you an experienced assistant?
It would help if your lot found out who was trying to wreck this place.
Wreck it? What are you talking about?
I mean what I said.
So what are you going to do? Does he carry on working or what?
Well, it's up to you, Alex. Do we get rid of Hooper?
It's impossible. He's working flat out and we're still having problems.
Look, it could be he's doing more harm than good.
But you think he's not doing his job?
Apparently the guy's always been pretty flaky, but now he's saying there's a saboteur on board.
And you don't believe him?
Well, Hooper's overworked. He knows that Wolfhart's doing his safety rounds. Maybe he's screwing things up to get himself noticed.
No, that can't be true.
That's just a theory.
I still say we cannot get rid of him.
Well, do you know any alternatives?
There is one. What say we get him an assistant to keep an eye on him for us?
Do you know any trained engineers up for grabs?
Yes, I do. You.
Hey, Nathan, wait a minute.
David,
come on.
David, no. I know it's not our job, but things are a bit slack at the moment. And if there is something going down beyond practical jokes, we ought to know about it.
Good. Well, that's settled then. Are you coming back by my office? It doesn't matter what
yes. Yes, sir.
Wait a minute, boss man. I agreed to play bridge, okay? But now what? Do you expect me to crawl around fixing the heating pipes?
Yes, I do.
Anything else, just whistle. You do know how to whistle, don't you?
You just put your lips together and you blow, sweetheart.
She says it.
Yes, you're right. So she did.
That psychiatrist we invited, you know, I'm having second thoughts.
Why, has somebody complained?
Not exactly. Wolfhartt thinks it's a waste of time.
What does it matter what Wolfhartt thinks?
That report he's filing could matter a great deal. He's seen two accidents already. If it's going to keep him happy, we could put off Dr. Parr, hmm?
It's too late. Well, Doc is landing in a couple of hours. Besides, if people are behaving like Hooper, that's a very good reason why we need her.
Job 943 completed. All systems automatic. What's next?
There was a power surge to the card table in Recreation 3.
So there was.
Bless you.
Oh. How is the Charles the girl?
Oh, very Gallic. Brought you back a present.
Oh, thank you. Oh.
So, where's the boss?
Nathan? He's on his way to pick up Dr. Parr.
Yeah? Who's Dr. Parr?
Did Nathan tell you?
And if Nathan heard the 3-minute warning, he'd probably keep me in the dark.
She's a psychiatrist. She's coming here on an attachment.
Yeah? As long as she doesn't attach herself to me.
I'm sure you'll make her welcome when she arrives.
Now, what makes you think that? I hate shrinks.
Oh, Kenzie, I know you're a warm-hearted person.
Yeah? You're confusing me with someone else. So, what kind of attachment?
Well, she's doing a psychiatric assessment of all MU-based personnel. It's voluntary, except for us.
You mean we don't have to do it?
No, I mean it's compulsory for us.
Yeah? Did Nathan put us up for this?
I don't know.
Oh, I'll bet he did. Where did you say he was?
Moon Rover 3. Kenzie.
Anna, you tell me to bend like the willow and I'll throw up.
Moonbase to Rover 3.
Hello, Kenzie. What can I do for you?
You can tell me what's going on.
You got a duty roster there.
I meant to tell me about Dr. Parr.
Then why didn't you say so?
Because I'd forgotten how evasive you can be.
She's a psychiatrist.
She's coming here.
That's right. Any problem?
It's just that you present these things as fait accomplis.
Your accent could be improved.
Yeah, well, so could your attitude. You're so bloody secretive, we never know what the hell to expect.
Watch your language, Kenzie. This isn't a private conversation.
Yeah, well, there's no such thing as privacy out here, Nathan. That's why no one wants a shrink hanging around. Least of all a police shrink. I won't be associated with it.
You will if I tell you to. Look, I realize it's difficult.
I'm not the only one. You start mucking around with people's heads and you'll have a mutiny on your hands.
If I were you, Kenzie, I'd shut up right now. Screen off.
Well, up yours too.
What were you? What's up with her?
She was having an argument with Nathan.
Yeah, I've been having an argument with that drinks machine. Still doesn't understand English. You ever heard of chocolate orange juice? OK, what am I supposed to be on?
Anything you like?
Oh, great. How about a game of Hide the Sausage?
Ah, you want to have a sex?
Well, not right now, but you can fit me in about 2:30. That'd be lovely.
Sorry, I'm not interested.
No, no one is anymore. So what we need is some new blood. Screen on.
Perhaps the new psychiatrist.
What new psychiatrist?
Nathan's having a meeting with her, a Dr. Angela Parr.
Oh, no.
Hi, Hooper.
The hell are you doing here?
I'm your new assistant.
I asked for a trained engineer, not a police snoop.
Trained?
Get your thieving hands off my tools.
Listen, Hooper, I've been assigned to help you. Why don't you just try and put up with me? What you working on? Hear your car shifts off sick. Okay, Hooper, suit yourself. Nathan said you've been having a tough time recently, so we thought we'd give you some help.
Job 605 completed. Malfunction of the card table was traced to junction box 400/86B, which seems to have been wrongly rewired. If more people did what they were supposed to around here, there'd be a lot less bloody accidents.
You know, I was afraid you were going to ask me to get some information for you.
My reputation that bad?
A man gets posted out here and publicly runs a security check on his colleagues. What would you deduce from that?
That you've been doing some research on me.
Other people's secrets are my business.
So they're mine. That's why I ran the check.
Do you find it difficult to trust people?
Are you analyzing me?
No, just interested. You're pretty famous, you know.
What as? Best copper on the moon.
Skepticism is one of the things you're famous for, and you're avoiding my question.
What about trusting people? Well, that's a pretty difficult thing for a copper. Especially out here, people living on top of each other, well, they become unpredictable.
Really?
You don't think so?
I don't think there's any such thing as an unpredictable action.
Really? Well, perhaps you can help me with this, then. Our top maintenance engineer, he's a 10-year man. He starts falling behind with his work, threatening people, talking about sabotage. What do you think about that, then?
He could need antidepressants, he could need a kick in the pants, or he could just need a pay rise.
Well, you make things sound very simple.
The brain is a simple organ, Commander Spring. I'll get your people straightened out for you.
I think you may find some of our people rather resistant to being straightened out.
I'm used to that.
God, I don't know how to smell this.
This drinks machine fights back.
Right.
Well, he's got third-degree burns to his...
Sensitive parts, yeah. Apart from that, he's never felt better.
This is getting ridiculous.
Yeah, that's what Wolfhartt said.
Oh, don't tell me he was here.
Yeah, just out of range. He ain't got much of a sense of humour, is he?
Where's David, now?
Well, last time I saw him, he had a screwdriver in his hand and an evil gleam in his eye.
Do you want to speak to him?
No, I can't. I'm waiting for Dr. Parr. What? Here? Oh, God.
I'll be down there, your firing range.
Just where are you going?
Well, I need to break it to her gently. Jim, what are you... What's he talking? Break what?
I don't know.
You're looking confused, Commander.
This place is going mad.
Just as well I'm here.
It's not my fault. I didn't invite a bloody woman.
Well, I'm not mad at you. I'm mad at Nathan. I mean, the guy's got a conspiracy complex. He's using Dr. Parr to interrogate us.
I've got no secrets to hide, have you?
Oh, well, if you're such a bloody open book, why don't you stop bugging me and go and see the woman? She's expecting someone.
Not expecting me. The last person she's going to expect.
Good luck.
This is duff. Give me yours.
There's nothing wrong.
Come on. That's better.
Well, why are you the last person she's expecting? I mean, do you know her?
I should do. I was married to her for 3 years.
What?
What? You reckon she looks too sophisticated for me?
That's not a tall order. Can I have my gun back?
No.
Colin?
We did have a couple of other things in common.
Yeah, well, don't press them up against me. Nothing wrong with this one.
So it seems.
Why don't you go and say hello to her?
Because she hates me. All my ex-wives hate me.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. Ask her. She's a psychiatrist.
Oh, I'm going near her.
So who is?
You are?
Anishun.
Anishun?
Park Kenzie didn't want to come.
Did she say why?
She feels it is an invasion of her privacy.
Do you?
No. I see it as my duty.
Duty? Yes. Japanese are very keen on that word. Do you enjoy your duty?
I enjoy being a good employee.
And what if your personal beliefs should conflict with your duty?
I do not allow the two to conflict.
You killed a man in the course of your duty. How do you feel about that?
I had to choose.
I asked you how you felt about it. Horror? Guilt? Self-disgust? You must realize, as a doctor, that this kind of sudden emotional shock can be quite disorientating. I wouldn't be at all surprised if you reacted with some kind of antisocial behavior.
My colleague at the time was very supportive.
And which colleague was that?
Colin Davis.
Who? He works here.
Do you know him?
Oh, my God. Where were we?
The disorienting effect of a sudden emotional shock.
Were we? I see. Well, look, do you think we could continue this at some other time?
One. One, two.
Leigh!
The hell are you doing up there?
One, two, three.
Well?
Some joker wired this to the machine.
I told your boss there was somebody mucking about with this system.
So you did.
Hey, we're just gonna leave it like this then, are we?
Yes.
Hand me a cross clipper.
Crossed clipper.
3mm key.
3mm key.
Power sealer.
Powered sealer.
Hey! You're not bad for a turkey.
Hello. Hi. Cup of tea, milk, and more sugar.
How was your interview?
Oh, rather short.
Good on you. Hope you told her to get lost.
Oh, it wasn't necessary. She had a few problems of her own, you know.
Yeah? Well, they always do.
You, speaking from your experience?
Oh, well, it's all bullshit, isn't it? I mean, nobody knows why you crack up. You can blame anything. You can blame drugs, blame your parents. You can blame living in space.
It's impossible to tell. We all learn to compensate.
Yeah. I suppose so.
Are there any prints on this?
No, nothing.
So he is still in the clear.
The hell he is! Look, Nathan. This thing has been rigged to respond to my voice. My voice! You're always talking about detective's nose. Well, I'm using mine, and I can smell Hooper from here.
I think your personal dislike of the man is affecting your judgment.
My judgment?
Yes.
Okay, ask somebody else. Ask that, that pet psychiatrist of yours. That's what she's here for, isn't it?
Anna's advised me against that.
You see, Dr. Parr is not the most tactful of people. I think forcing Mr. Hooper to go and see her would be a mistake.
So what do we do? Hope he volunteers.
No, no, just stay with him, will you, David?
Stay with him and do what?
Do nothing. Just stay with him and be nice to him.
Well, you have no idea how difficult that's gonna be.
Edge?
Good evening, Colin.
Oh, yeah. Heard you were on the premises.
Nice of you to contact me.
Well, I knew you'd be busy. You, spotted any loonies yet?
No one as damaged as yourself.
Well, I'm a reformed character.
That's not what I've heard.
A drinks machine. I suppose we should be grateful it wasn't something major.
It might have been, Alex. It might well have been. Too many things go wrong. I have a bad feeling about this place. A lot of the staff seem very tense to me. Tense people make mistakes.
It's a combination of factors. We've had some bad luck, and now with this psychiatrist visiting...
I didn't come here for excuses.
Ernest, you don't have to beat me with a stick. I am as unhappy about this as you are.
I'm sorry. You're right. We need to have a talk. Why don't we discuss it over a bottle of your vodka?
That's a very good idea.
Ah, I'm sorry. I thought you'd have finished.
Ah, come in. Make yourself at home. I know just the place. This is where I come to relax.
It's wonderful. Hannah would have liked it.
Hannah's your wife?
She was. She died a couple of months ago. 2 months and 12 days ago.
Sorry.
It was a good idea coming here, Alex. I know I've been breathing down your neck.
Oh, it's your job.
Perhaps. It's the scale of things that makes me so cross. Card tables and drink dispensers. I should have retired last year.
Oh, come on, Ernest. You're still a major force out here.
I'm an old man.
Yes, yes, yes. You're both old men.
But it has its moments. That poor policeman with the coffee all down his trousers. It isn't funny.
No, it's not at all funny.
It could happen to you.
No, it couldn't. Hmm? I only drink tea.
It's a very good vodka.
Yes, the best. Hey, you know, if there's any consolation, you're not alone. The personnel department still send me their little problem cases. This is like the sewage recycling unit. All the small bits float to the top, where you and I have to deal with them.
Doesn't it make you feel worthless?
Mm-hmm. Look at that. Look at all that, huh? A billion galaxies. A billion, billion star systems. And no human has managed to escape Alan. You feel futile, huh? Of course you do. Who doesn't?
Kenzie.
Yeah. Ah, morning, David. How's the new job going?
It sucks. I've lost Hooper. He was supposed to meet me here first thing this morning.
Yeah? Where are you?
Exit 83, right at the end of the complex. I think that jerk was trying to get me out of the way.
Could be. I'll see if I can trace him for you, eh?
Ah, Dr. Pavenko. Good of you to spare the time.
I realize it's important.
Indeed.
Yes.
I really appreciate being able to use your office.
Oh, it's my pleasure. You know, sometimes I feel guilty about taking up all the space.
These feelings of guilt, how long have they troubled you?
I said I sometimes feel guilty. Most of the time, I manage to live with myself.
And yet your office is underutilized.
Possibly.
And you feel demeaned by much of your work.
No, what gave you that idea?
I talked to Mr. Wolfhartt last night, and he said you expressed feelings of futility.
I said no such thing.
I can't see why Mr. Wolfhartt would lie to me.
I may have said something in confidence to reassure him. He's the one who feels futile, not me.
You think Mr. Wolfhartt is unbalanced?
I think there is a danger in accepting what people have said too literally.
That is how the subconscious speaks to us.
My dear young lady, I know very well how the subconscious speaks to us, and it is not through spies.
There's no need to be aggressive, Dr. Kravenko.
I'm not being aggressive.
I'm afraid you are. Would you say this was outside your normal personality?
If you mean, do I have insight, the answer is yes. And I know when I'm being goaded.
I'm not goading you, Alex. I really think you need to talk to me.
No. I need to talk to Wolfhartt. Good day.
Put a call out for Pal Kenzie.
Came to see you.
Tough.
Well, the shape's been stood up. I should know.
Why don't you go and see him then?
Have either of you seen Wolfhartt?
No, but I can put a call out for him.
I just did that. They can't locate him.
Maybe he's hiding from the shrink.
I doubt it. They weren't so well together. If you see him, I'm in the recreation area.
We'll let him know.
What was all that about? Next, please.
You're not Pal Kenzie, either.
She can make it.
I've told you already, Colin, we have nothing to say to one another.
Well, I needed to share my innermost thoughts with someone I thought was a too good an opportunity to miss.
Your personal computer has a psychotherapy program.
Yeah, but it doesn't have tits.
Colin, if you came here to be offensive...
I came here to see a psychiatrist. You're the professional.
What's your problem?
Ever since I've been out here, I've been really randy.
You were pretty rampant on Earth, as I remember.
Still have dreams about you, Ange.
I have those too. I wake up screaming.
Oh, come on, it wasn't that bad.
Oh, I've got a selective memory. I'm sure it was a lot worse.
Your present husband any better?
I don't have a present husband.
Great, I'll come back home then.
No, thanks. I feel safer with you here.
Well, all right, I'll work here and come back home on leave.
Colin, you don't know what home is. The army, then the police force, now this. You're institutionalized. You should accept that.
Still a very beautiful woman, Ange.
And you're still a chancer.
Process.
Where's Colin?
Having his head examined.
Really? I thought it was you that was supposed to be having their head examined. It's you she's expecting.
She's going to be disappointed then. Process.
Kenzie, how can I expect other people to volunteer when my own staff don't agree to be vetted?
You can't.
Look, everyone out here works under some kind of pressure. Now, doesn't it bother you that one day one of those people just might go crazy? Well, I know it bothers me.
Well, then it's your problem and not mine.
Well, then you make it your problem. Just think of the consequences if they did. There's 101 things around here could go very badly wrong.
All right, well, you tell me how having some overbearing shrink out here is going to stop it happening, eh? I mean, you and I know why people crack up out here, mate. There's no bloody room to move. It's ironic, isn't it? There's a million miles of nothingness out here and we have to live in sardine tins together.
I just want to set an example.
You're just trying to rifle through other people's thoughts, and I, for one, am not going to put up with it.
I am just asking you to go to an interview, that's all.
And I'm just telling you to leave me alone.
Oh, to hell with you. You come with me.
What?
Come.
Nathan, you...
Yes, oh, that's right. You come with me. Come on.
You...
Come.
Where the hell have you been?
Some bugger's nicked my toolbox. That Anderson woman hasn't left Moonbase yet, has she?
You better have a damn good attorney.
Exit 1-4. That's your part of the building.
The doors are tight.
What's going on?
It's either a decompression drill or a real blowout.
You mean we're locked in?
Better in than out. Power cut is nice.
Well, what do we do?
We let them sort it out. Do you play chess? No, no, of course you don't.
No, and neither do you.
Right, let's see what we got. One blanket.
What's that?
Breakfast. Oh, that's nice.
I'm scared, Colin.
Do you want a cuddle?
Not that scared.
Okay, Hooper. You go your way and I'll go mine.
That must have been one hell of a leap to reach this far.
Yep. Certainly gets drafty when they leave the doors open.
Yeah. Maybe Hooper was right.
About a saboteur?
anyone did this for kicks, they got to be out of their tree. I suppose I should thank you for saving my life.
Well, don't speak too soon, Kinsey. Besides, he'd have probably managed by himself.
Oh, with a broken arm.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
Can I have attention, please? Can I have your attention, please? There has been an explosion in one of the airlocks. The corridors throughout this sector have decompressed. So I'm afraid we are here until the rescue team arrives. I hope you'll be patient.
No one's seen Wolfhartt recently.
Maybe he's in his sleeping cell.
I called him just before the accident and got no reply. He could easily have been in a corridor when we lost pressure.
Oh, don't worry. He has spent many years in this place. I'm sure he knows how to look after himself.
He's not as young as he was. You know, they lost 5 people in the Coral Sea disaster. 3 of them were over 60.
I'm sure he'll be okay.
Some food here. You hungry?
No, thanks.
Well, what should we talk about then, eh?
What?
Well, it's that or we can start screaming. Why are you so stubborn about seeing that shrink?
Well, you never give up, do you?
No, not if I can help it, no.
Okay, I just never met one that did anything but damage, okay?
Well, you can't have met that many.
I've met a few.
Yeah? When was that?
When I was younger. Nathan, sit down.
Yeah. Well, well, well. So Kenzie doesn't like shrinks, does he?
No, Kenzie doesn't like shrinks.
Why do you think that is, then?
Because they never know when to stop asking questions.
Is he okay?
Yes, no problem. There are 2 or 3 others who might go if the oxygen pressure keeps dropping.
I know. I'm one of them.
How much longer do you think the air will last?
Well, a lot of people in here. Half an hour. An hour at the most.
The help will be on the way.
I hope so.
Right. I want 300 meters of steel hose and a dozen universal connectors. Go! Oh. What the hell are you doing here?
I heard the alarm. I thought you might need some help.
Well, stop gawping and fix that seal.
You know, your trouble, Kenzie, is you've got too many secrets.
Heard some bizarre stuff, Nathan, but that one really takes the cake. You know, I don't know a damn thing more about you than I did the day we started. You're always probing, but you never give a damn thing away about yourself.
Yes, maybe you're right. Maybe I inherited it from my father.
What was he? Quiz show host.
No, he was a computer salesman. It was the best that recondite ever had. Researched the market inside out. Wiped the floor with the opposition.
Well, if he was so crash hot, how come Recondite went down the path?
Sabotage. By the end of it, half of their new projects are being stolen right off the drawing board. Sunk them in the end.
They ever catch the snoop?
Not soon enough. Put this fresh detective on the job. He's a nice enough sort of guy. Not too pushy. Didn't like to pressurize people. Mucked about it for a year before he found out who did it. Turned out to be Recondite's most trusted employee.
I thought you said your father was their most trusted employee.
He was.
Who is the copper? Do you think we're going to die?
Well, I hope not. I haven't seen Naples yet.
I'll say this for you, Colin. You were always good in a crisis.
No, we were never in a crisis.
Our whole marriage was a crisis. Oh. I'm cold.
Last chance.
You're unbelievable.
What, can you think of a better way to go?
Show a bit of sensitivity, Colin. I'm scared to death.
They say fear is a great aphrodisiac.
No, they don't.
Don't they?
No.
Hmm. Sure, I read it somewhere.
I've heard it's not a bad way to die. The hypoxia is meant to give you a sense of elation.
Death is only a milestone.
You know something, Anna? You are a very remarkable woman.
Should take about another hour.
We don't have another hour.
Well, it's the only source of pressure we've got.
No, it's not. The service corridors will still be pressurized. We'll bleed them.
Red, oxygen, blankets, come on. Let's help these folk.
Christ, it was down to 12%.
Oh, just in time.
Just in time in here. Come on, what's this? A public holiday? There's people through this bulkhead. Get out of the way.
Oh.
Jeez.
Ernest Wolfhartt, I was expecting you here when the explosion happened.
Could he be in your office?
It's possible.
Theroux!
Get me.
I've got a job for you.
Shut the bloody door!
Is there anything we can do to help?
No, I think Colin's on top of the situation.
Through. I found your mate.
Is the whole place repressurized?
Just about. We had to steal some air off the service corridors.
Any casualties?
Not so far. Old man Krivenko's looking for Wolfhartt.
You did check those corridors were clear?
If there was anyone down there, he got what was coming.
Through. Service corridors. Priority.
Got it.
I've got him. He's here.
Coffee.
No.
Well. Would you believe it, eh? Ernest Wolfhartt. You know, I reckon he must have been bloody bonkers.
That's a very sophisticated diagnosis.
Well, he says he didn't know what he was doing. Do you believe that?
Believe it? I've experienced it. A bizarre collection of circumstances, a freak aberration from the norm.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about a certain fevered embrace that took place. Ridiculous, though it now seems.
Oh, come on, you seem pretty keen at the time.
You caught me at a vulnerable moment.
Oh. Well, let me know when the next one comes along, eh?
Not before the next shuttle.
You're definitely going, then.
Nothing would persuade me to stay.
Bye, Ench. I'll miss you.
You said that 10 years ago. I didn't believe it then, either.
Excuse me, was that Dr. Parr just leaving?
Yeah. Well, is there a problem?
No, it's just that I had an appointment with her.
Really? Only, I am her assistant, so perhaps if you wanted to come to my office...
Thank you, Inspector. Hello, Mr. Hooper. We did well, didn't we? I just thought I'd come to say goodbye.
Goodbye.
I hear your cross shift finally made it, then.
Yeah, typical, when there's no work to do.
So you'll be back in a couple of months?
I don't suppose they'd manage without me.
Well, I'll be here if you ever need me.
No, thanks. I'm fine on my own.
They say that loneliness can send you mad. But you know the worst thing about living out here? I'll tell you. Boredom. You forget how much stimulation you get back there. We used to spend a lot of time in the garden. Hannah liked to prune everything, but I liked it wild. I liked the feeling of things getting out of hand.
Is that why you started tampering with things?
Perhaps. I don't know anymore. Do you despise me, Alex?
No, I feel sorry.
Sorry for me.
No. Just sorry.
David's still on the rampage. He reckons Hooper must have known there was someone down there. What do you think?
Well, let's just say I've learned to stop probing. Kenzie.
Hmm?
Listen, the stuff I told you about my father, I trust I can rely upon your discretion.
Yeah, I won't tell a soul.
Thanks, Kenzie.
Not while we're getting on so well.
Kenzie.
Hmm?
Excuse me sounding suspicious, but I didn't detect a slight note of blackmail in your voice there, did I?
Come on, Nathan, you should know me by now. I mean, would I do a thing like that? Would I?
She crossed the stars.
shelter.